Dear students, in this video, we are going to see the checked and unchecked exception in Java. So first, we know that all your built-in exceptions are available in the package called as java.lang package. So if you want to explore it, you can just go with system library and then you have this java.base. So the system library only we have all our default packages, and under that we have the package called as java.lang package. So inside the java.lang package we have all the built-in exceptions. So we have the exceptions such as arithmetic exception, array index out of bound exception, and then we have the class cast exception, class not found exception, and then we have the generic exception class called as exception, and then we have illegal monitor state, illegal argument exception, illegal access exception, index out of bound exception. So all the built-in exceptions are available under the package called as java.lang. Generally, this built-in exceptions are divided into two types. One is called as checked exception and another is called as the unchecked exception. So what is mean by checked exception? So checked exceptions are checked during the compile time. So checked exceptions are checked during the compile time. These are the some of the checked exceptions from the built-in exception: SQL exception, IO exception, class not found, file not found, and then invocation target exception. These are some of the examples of the checked exception. So now if you want to handle the checked exception, you can either use two ways. So the first way you can use with the throws keyword. You can use with the throws keyword, and the next way is you can use with the try and catch block. So checked exceptions, you can handle it in two ways. So you can handle in two ways. So handle in two ways. So first way is by using the throws keyword or by using the try catch block. And now generally this exception will be working for the sensitive information. Okay, so for example, you are using a database connectivity. So that type of exceptions, and also if I want to try to open a file. So like that, the sensitive informations will be handled by the checked exception. And this checked exception is the inherited from, so it is inherited from the generic exception class. The checked exceptions are inherited from the generic exception class. So now we'll see one checked exception. So by using the throw keyword, I am throwing a checked exception, IO exception demo. So when you use the checked exception, so this is now checked exception. Okay, so checked exceptions are generally checked during the compile time. So IO exception, so this we have to import the namespace, so we have imported. But still we are getting an error, throw new IO exception. So it is telling it is an unhandled exception. So when I compile the program, during the compilation itself, I cannot compile it because that exception is thrown during the compilation itself. So java.language, that is an error because unhandled exception. So checked exception must be handled. So checked exception must be handled. So to handle it only, we are having two ways, either by using the throws keyword or by using the try catch block. So if you see here itself, it will tell you you want to resolve it. So you can use with add throws declaration. So automatically we are getting the throws keyword. So by using the throws IO exception, so now it is handled. So when I run it, no problem will happen. So it is running properly. Okay, because it is throwing an error only runtime, but during the compilation there is no error coming. This is one way of handling the checked exception. So the other way to handle this exception is using the try catch block. So I can put try and this thing I have to do the catch. So IO exception E. So I handle it S out exception E. Okay, so now also the compile time we are not getting any error, so we can able to compile it properly. So during the runtime only it will throw the exception, and that exception is handled by the catch block. Okay, so checked exception means during the compile time itself you have to check the exception and handle it. So in order to handle it, you can either use the throws keyword or you can use with the try catch block. And now we will see the next type of exception. The next type of exception is unchecked exception. So unchecked exception means it is not checked during the compile time. Okay, so compile time, this unchecked exception will not produce any errors. So the examples are null pointer exception, array index out of bound exception, illegal argument exception, number format exception, arithmetic exception. So that all will come under unchecked exception. So these exceptions will happen only during runtime. So during runtime only these exceptions will happen. So it is also called runtime exception. It is also called, the other name for it is runtime exception. So this will be inherited from, this unchecked exceptions are inherited from runtime exception. So this unchecked exceptions are inherited from runtime exception class. And here this exception will handle with less sensitive information. So less sensitive information you can do with the unchecked exception. Very sensitive information means it will be handled with the checked exception. Okay, so unchecked exception means it will not check your errors during the compile time. These are the some of the example. This exception will happen only during the runtime. So the other name for unchecked exception is runtime exception. This runtime exceptions, it will happen during runtime. So the unchecked exceptions are inherited from the runtime exception class, and this exception will handle generally less sensitive information. So now we will go with the unchecked exception. So I am throwing new arithmetic exception. Arithmetic exception is the unchecked exception. So if I throw, even though I am not using any try block, catch block, throws keyword, this exception, this unchecked exception will not produce any error during the compilation. Okay, during the compilation it won't produce any error. So if you run it, so during the runtime, so compilation it is not producing any error. So during the runtime only we will get the exception. So during the runtime only this unchecked exception will throw the exception. So this is the main difference between checked and unchecked exception. Checked exceptions are checked during compile time. Unchecked exceptions are not checked during the compile time. And to handle the checked exception, so you must handle the exception, then only you can be able to compile the program. So in order to handle, you can have two solution. One is by using the throws keyword or by using the try catch block. But here runtime exceptions, the unchecked exceptions are happen during runtime. So the other name for it is called runtime exceptions. And this checked exceptions are inherited from the generic exception class. Unchecked exceptions are inherited from the runtime exception class. And this checked exceptions must be handled, but unchecked exception during the compile time you need not to handle it, because it will happen only during the runtime. And here if you have any sensitive information, that you can do with the checked exception. So if you have less sensitive information, that you can do with the unchecked exception. Thank you.